In this video, we'll prepare a floor made using a floor generator for export to Unreal. To determine the dimensions of the floor parts for baking the texture of the floor generator, I did some test renders and set the resolution of 2048 by 2048 pixels on 3 square meters of floor. For a rough understanding of the scale, let's place a plane measuring 1 by 3 meters next to the floor. So let's convert the floor with the floor generator and multi-texture into an editable poly. Press 5. Detach the required number of elements. Shortcut is assigned to detach, so you don't have to look for it in the list. Remember the number of the fragment. Highlight the separated section of the floor. Create a second unwrapping channel by sending the model with the use of Rizom. While the model is loading, set the resolution to 2048, remove the gap between the elements. F4. This is the object selection mode. Empirically, I determined that the elements are packed more tightly if you deploy part of the thin strips and leave the other part as it is. First we wrap large sections, then attach horizontal sections to them, and at the end we wrap with vertical sections for the third time. Press Ctrl plus S and send the unwrapping to 3ds Max. Done. Now our model has the first map channel left over from the floor generator and the second one prepared in Rizom. Then we need to transfer the diffuse map from the first channel to the unwrapping of the second channel, previously prepared in Rizom. And at the same time we bake all the maps, connected to the diffuse channel of the floored material into one picture. Press 0 on the keyboard, and the dialog box render to texture opens here. Put a checkmark in this checkbox, select the second unwrapping channel, into which you need to bake the texture from the first channel. At first I was confused about what number to put where. Attention, let's turn on the fantasy. I imagined the first unwrapping channel and the bottom number as a frying pan that we are going to heat up during rendering, and the upper number on which we need to bake is a lid. Let's warm up the first channel. It is logically located at the bottom. Texture of the floor generator warms up. It's partially evaporated, then transferred to the second channel and deposited on the borders of the unwrapping, which we just prepared in Rizom. It sounds a bit crazy, but you'll remember that once and for all. Then add texture elements, Corona diffuse color, which should pass to save file. Then there is an opportunity to select the resolution. We set 2048 and hit render. Whilst rendering, we prepare the material which will be applied to this section of the floor. Since we are not moving the material to Unreal, more like for visual inspection or the work done. And for render, for example, inside 3ds Max after baking the textures from floor generator. Done. The texture is rendered. Upload it into the bitmap slot. Assign the material to a separate section of the floor. Click the Show Material button to visually define the boundaries of the work done. We see that our section of the floor doesn't look good yet. That's because there's still an unwrapping of the floor generator on the first channel. A new texture is distributed or baked within the unwrapping that we've just made in Rizom. They're different, obviously. Using a standard method, we can jump to a second channel by clicking Abandon and immediately go back by clicking Move and not return empty-handed. Let's clarify the meaning of the Move and Abandon buttons. The word to abandon is to leave, give up, forsake, and the word Move means relocating. You obviously take your stuff with you when you move to another place. When we want to move from one channel to another without dragging the unwrapping, we abandon the unwrapping on the channel, which we are leaving. But if we want to duplicate the unwrapping and take the copy with us, we click Move. The map that we bake along the contour of unwrapping in Rizom and basically the unwrapping that we took from the second channel. So we made the unwrapping on the first channel for textures. We make the unwrapping on the second channel for baking the light in a standard way as shown in lecture. In order to reduce the number of clicks during routine operations, I found a script that copies the unwrapping from one channel to another. Just like Bridge Rizom script, it's always open during a continuous work. Good luck, everyone!